The Ultimate Guide to Ethereum Liquid Staking in 2023. ETH Liquid Staking, Lido Staking, Liquid Staking Derivatives. So many buzzwords, so little time. So let's dive into what is Ethereum Liquid Staking. First, we have to understand the issue with staking on Ethereum. After the merge last September, staking on Ethereum now generates real yield as validators stake 32 ETH to secure the network and also earn rewards in the process. However, this 32 ETH is locked up, at least for now. As a capital efficient degen, that doesn't sound good. Enter liquid staking. For those too lazy to check the glossary, it refers to unlocking your staked ETH via derivatives so you can reinvest it elsewhere. What is ETH liquid staking derivatives, or LSD? No, we're not talking about that LSD. In explain like I'm five terms, it simply means you get a new token that's worth the same as the staked ETH, and you can use it to ape into a new yield farm or protocol. Liquid staking does away with the main downside of staking. You can now access your capital and utilize it more efficiently. The most popular LSD in the market right now is Lido Staking ETH, or STETH, with over $7.7 billion worth of ETH staked and over 260,000 stakers. Why is liquid staking important? As a novice DeFi degen, you may wonder what is the main benefit of liquid staking. It's called rehypothecation.
Re-what?
In ape terms, rehypothecation is using assets pledged as collateral in several places. So, for instance, if you use your home to secure a car loan and a loan for another house, that would be rehypothecating your house. Liquid staking ETH allows staking ETH to secure Ethereum, loan one, and then you use the same staked ETH as collateral called staked ETH to stake and secure, say, a DeFi loan or loan. Too. But why would you stake ETH in the first place? Well, because not doing it means you're losing out on staking yield. Like any other proof of stake protocol, staking yields are an implicit tax on non-stakers. If you don't want to secure the protocol, fine, then don't complain when others get paid yield for doing so. But the following Messari chart comparing the share of staked ETH to other blockchains has been making the rounds on Twitter. Ethereum staking ratio is lower because A, there is more economic utility to ETH, and B, you can't unstake it yet, but the latter is about to change. Blockchain researcher Hasu in Paradigm CTO estimated that 15 to 30% of ETH may be staked without liquid staking. But with liquid staking, this number may surge to 80% or more. An added benefit would be an increased economic security of Ethereum. The more ETH staked, the more staked ETH, the derivative an attacker has to acquire. The more additional steps there are, the more difficult it becomes. So you can think of liquid staking protocols offering this service as banks for staked collateral. Some providers are centralized while others are decentralized. And even MetaMask has jumped on the liquid staking hype train and offers an integration with staking providers from its dApp. And hype train is definitely not an exaggeration. Just look at the token prices of some staking providers over the last month. Liquid staking is becoming a dominant narrative now because of the up-and-coming Ethereum Shanghai upgrade. But what is the Ethereum Shanghai upgrade? The Ethereum Shanghai upgrade will allow users to unstake their ETH. And since Ethereum switched to proof of stake, staked ETH was stuck unless you used a liquid staking provider. This upgrade will finally enable withdrawals from Ethereum and also bring down the unstaking time to 27 hours. Here's a timeline for the Shanghai upgrade. Here's some interesting data from the ETH Beacon Chain Dune dashboard. And all data is as of January 19th, 2023. 13.38% of ETH is staked. The liquid staking market share is 32.96%. 29.12% is staked through Lido. Around 65% of staked ETH is underwater. Why is this so important? Because some fear the Shanghai upgrade could lead to selling pressure. However, a couple of arguments indicate the contrary. We can't reliably predict what share of ETH is underwater, or in the money will prefer to take profits or cut losses. The upgrade will enable full withdrawals, but only 6 validators can exit per epoch. An epoch is 6.4 minutes for Ethereum. Consequently, only 1,350 validators can exit daily. So 43,200 ETH a day. And that amounts to only 0.8% of daily ETH trading volume and also should be easily absorbed by the market. Partial withdrawal will be able to withdraw the excess 2 ETH in rewards each validator has staked on average, multiplied by a bit more than 500,000 validators. That amounts to roughly 1 million ETH hitting the market. And that is still only 10% of ETH's daily trading volume, even before we consider that these stakers are likely to restake much of their balance. So TLDR, sustained selling pressure on ETH may be unlikely. What to consider when choosing a liquid staking provider? So you could of course stake ETH yourself. The downside is that that will cost you 32 ETH, which is the minimum amount to run a node. And you won't be able to rehypothecate your staked ETH even after the Shanghai upgrade. Lucky for you, there are a plethora of centralized and decentralized staking providers. Data from Dune indicates that 33% of all ETH is staked with decentralized providers, compared to 28% at centralized exchanges. Lido has a controlling 87.5% market share among those decentralized providers, and on the other hand, Coinbase, Kraken, and Binance hold significant shares of all staked ETH. At Blue Collar Chain put together an excellent list of important factors to consider for liquid staking providers. Tokenomics: is the yield from your liquid staking provider real yield in ETH or inflated with the provider's native token? Protocol revenue model: does the staking service provide products other than just liquid staking, so i.e. greater utility? Current and fully diluted market cap: how is the token doing now and how much more inflation is there to come? Smart contract risk: are there contracts, audits, bug bounty programs, and does the team have a history? DPEG risk: how much runway or treasury does the service have? Frequency and type of taxable events: what type of reward does the service use, and are you subject to capital gains or income tax? Tokens that are useful beyond being purely liquid staking derivatives will probably do better in the long run. Reward mechanisms of liquid staking tokens. Before diving into the protocol comparison, you should know about the three types of reward mechanisms. Rebasing tokens increase in amount with the yield. You get one staked ETH for one ETH. As your balance of ETH increases, so does your balance of staked ETH. Value accruing tokens increase in their price with the yield. You get one staked ETH for one ETH. As your balance of ETH increases, your balance of staked ETH remains the same, but also increases in value. The two token system keeps the principle the same. You get one staked ETH for one ETH. Your staking rewards are paid out in a separate reward token. The reward token has the same price as ETH, so 1% would result in 0.01 reward tokens. So next up, let's go into the Ethereum liquid staking providers comparison. Lido ETH staking. Reward type: value accruing token, STETH. Revenue model: 15% paid to pool validators, exclusively a staking service, but across several blockchains like Polygon, Solana, Polkadot, and Kusama. Staking APR: 4.86%, real yield paid in STETH. Tokenomics: 96% of tokens unlocked. Market cap and fully diluted value: 331 million to 612 million. Risk: audits done, $312 million treasury. Staking fee not redistributed to stakers via the native token. LDO is the clear market leader among decentralized staking pools. It has a high percentage of tokens unlocked and also provides staking services across different blockchains. Coinbase ETH staking. Reward type: value accruing token, SBETH. Fee: 25%. Staking APR: 3.89%. Risk: centralization. Coinbase offers convenient two-click staking within its centralized exchange product. Despite the custodial risk, Coinbase may grow its share thanks to its network effects. Binance ETH staking. Reward type: value accruing token, or BETH, and fee is 5%. Staking APR: 5%. Market cap and fully diluted value: 46 billion and 58 billion. Risk: centralization. Binance offers staking as one of its many products on the exchange. Compared to other centralized exchanges, Binance stands out with a slightly higher 5% staking APR and also lower 5% fee. Kraken ETH staking. Reward type: value accruing token, Ethereum 2.S. Fee: 15%. Staking APR: 4%. Risk: centralization. Kraken is another centralized staking provider that offers convenient access to its users. And also, the 15% fee charge sits in the middle between Binance and Coinbase. Rocket Pool ETH staking. Reward type: value accruing token, or RETH. Revenue model: 15%, 70% to node operators, 15% to Oracle DAO members, and 15% to treasury. Staking APR: 4.2% to 7.3%, depending on the position size and also matching RPL stake. Tokenomics: 5% inflation per annum. Market cap and fully diluted value: 331 million to 612 million. Risk: no revenue sharing. Revenue is generated via token inflation. RPL is the second biggest decentralized staking providers, and some think that it could actually overtake Lido in the long run, but for now, Rocket Pool has some bullish short-term catalysts. And next up is Frax ETH staking. Reward type: two token model. Revenue model: 10%, 90% to SFRX ETH holders, 8% to VE FX holders, 2% to insurance fund, several DeFi products like Frax. Staking APR is 6.7%, non-native yield. Staking APR is 6.7%. Tokenomics, 35% team share, 60% farming rewards, and 5% treasury. Market cap and fully diluted value, 671 million, 924 million. Risk check audits. Frax FXS is tipped to be one of the hottest protocols to challenge the existing market leaders. Its share of the liquid staking market has been growing rapidly thanks to a cleverly designed incentive mechanism that generates a high APR paid out partially in its native token. Frax also earns fees from the Curve protocol, benefiting FXS holders and also stakers. Next up, we have Anchor ETH staking. Reward type value coin token or AFB. Revenue model 10% to validator node. DeFi product suite. Staking APR 3.9%. Tokenomics capped supply according to its tokenomics. Market cap and fully diluted value 216 million and 224 million. Risks audit. Anchor provides liquid staking among several other DeFi services. Its token supply is almost fully unlocked, but it has performed worse than some of its biggest competitors. Stakewise ETH staking. Reward type 2 token model. Revenue model 10%. Staking APR 6.21%. Market cap and fully diluted value 25 million and 143 million. Risks 1.33 million treasury. High outstanding token emissions. Stakewise or Swise is another smaller staking provider. It suffers from rather high outstanding token emissions, although the token has performed quite well so far. Stater ETH staking. Reward type value accruing token. ETHX. Revenue model 10%, 10% DeFi management fee, multi-chain staking services. APR to be announced. Tokenomics, the distribution in the light paper. Market cap and fully diluted value 800 million and 123 million. Risks astronomical FDV compared to market cap, high outstanding token emissions. Stater SD is about to launch its ETH staking product and it already has a DeFi product suite and also multi-chain staking services, but suffers from a massive outstanding token inflation. Redacted ETH staking. Redacted is another wildcard DeFi protocol about to launch liquid staking. It is tipped to become a strong contender to more established protocols on Ethereum. Staked ETH are to over-collateralize a new stablecoin, Dinero, which will be usable as collateral across the DeFi landscape. ETH liquid staking strategies. There are three essential strategies to compound your yield from ETH liquid staking. The stablecoin strategy involves swapping the derivative token for stablecoins on a money market protocol and providing liquidity with these stablecoins. The strategy is safe as long as you monitor your collateralization level. A riskier strategy involves providing the derivative token as liquidity on an applicable protocol. This strategy incurs higher yield but carries the currency risk of remaining in ETH. The riskiest strategy is providing liquidity to an ETH protocol token pool. So for instance, for Lido, this would mean providing liquidity to the WSTETH LDO pool. So to do this, you would have to acquire the native protocol token, which will always be more volatile than ETH. The ETH liquid staking narrative is already going strong, but that does not mean that you are necessarily late. Ethereum upgrades and scaling will be one of the main narratives in 2023. Another intriguing project on the horizon is Agent Layer, which will allow users to validate and stake their liquid staked ETH in other protocols, thus earning from yield from two sources. But the good news is that decentralized pools are likely to win over centralized pools since they are more aligned with the Ethereum community and can compete with additional yield opportunities.